सहनाववतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः।
जन्माद्यस्य यतोऽन्वयादितरतः चार्थेष्वभिज्ञस्वराट् तेने ब्रह्महृदाय आदिकवये मुह्यन्ति यत्सूरयः तेजोवारिमृदां यथा विनिमयः यत्र त्रिसर्गो मृषा धाम्ना स्वेन सदा निरस्तकुहकं सत्यं परं धीमहि सच्चिदानन्दरूपाय। यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरह कातर आजुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तरवोऽभिनेदुः तं सर्वभूतहृदयम् नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये।
यस् सो यस्टर्डे वी हैड सीन वंस व्हेन द आचार्यास शंडा एंड अमरका वाज नॉट देयर इन द गुरुकुला प्रह्लादा कॉल्ड ऑल द Asura Balakas, all the boys, they wanted to play. But Prahlada said, come here, I want to tell you something. So all those boys, giving up all their playfulness, sat around Prahlada, attentively listening to him. So what did Prahlada say? Oh, my dear friends, life is very, very rare, especially to get a human birth. Is very difficult, and there is a great purpose in this human birth, and that is to attain the Supreme. So one must try one's level best in order to gain this state of Godhood, the state of perfection in this very birth itself. We should not waste time. As far as the pleasures of the world are concerned, it will anyway come to you. Because it is destined. You have taken this body in order to enjoy those pleasures. Just like the sufferings come to you unasked, in the same way, the pleasures also will come to you unasked. You don't have to put forth extra effort for it. You must put forth extra effort only to that thing which will not come to you unless you put forth effort. So therefore, don't waste time. Now, in order to emphasize this point, Prahlada analyzes life. What does he say?
Pumso varshashatam hyayuh tadartham chajitatmanah nishfalam yadasau ratriyam shetendham prapitastamah mugdhasya balye kaumare kridato yati vimshatih जरयाग्रस्त देहस्य यात्यकल्पस्य विंशतिः।
माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस अस्यूम दैट द ह्यूमन लाइफ स्पैन इज 100 इयर्स। आउट ऑफ दिस 100 इयर्स मुग्धस्य बाल्ये कौमार्ये क्रीडतः याति विंशतिः। 20 इयर्स गॉन इन चाइल्डिश इग्नोरेंस and playfulness of the early youth, balya and kaumara. 20 years gone. Another 20 years gone, Jaraya Grasta Dehasya, old age. So how many left now? Out of 100, the initial 20 and the last 20 gone. How many left? 60. Out of that, Tadardham Chajitatmanaha Nishfalam Yadasau Ratriyam Shete Andham Prapitastamaha. Out of that 60, 50% gone. In what? Sleep. For a person who is Ajitatmanaha, indulgent. Now how many is left? How many useful time is left? So out of 100, 20 gone, 20 gone, 60 left, 50% gone, 30 years left. So totally now 30 years are left with us for something creative, useful. And what do we do with that 30 years is what is described in the following verses. And these verses are bitter than even Bhajagovinda. So therefore, before entering into the bitter aspects of life, which mercilessly Prahlada is going to lash, I would like to give some padding. Keep some padding so that cushioning, so that the impact is little reduced. Bhagavatam is the most, sometimes you can say, brutally cruel text in some of the sections. So unless we understand, unless we have the whole picture, there is all the possibility that we may misunderstand the scripture. Right. So a little introduction before entering into this section. A child in the womb, say around 9 to 10 months, the child has to grow in the womb. Yes. And then alone the child has to come out. In the initial stages, the womb acts as a blessing for the child, because there are certain aspects of the physical construction which can be developed only in the womb. If the child comes out premature, the child will not be able to develop those aspects from the outer world, because in the outer world that facilities are not available. So the child has to remain in the womb, attain complete development, and then only the child has to come out. Yes or no? But suppose the child doesn't come out even after 10 months. Then what will happen? The cesarean, keep it aside. The mother also will not survive, the child also will not survive, isn't it? So very same womb which has been protecting the child becomes a death trap, isn't it? So in the initial stages, yes, the womb was acting as a blessing. But later on, a time must come when the very same womb the child has to leave. The prakriti, the nature, will force the child out. Isn't it? In the same way, not only in the womb, even when the child comes out, there are different wombs through which the child has to pass through as he grows. And what are the different wombs prescribed in the scriptures? Brahmacharyashrama, Grihasthashrama, Vanaprasthashrama and Sannyasashrama. These are all different wombs. You may not see the womb physically, but they are all wombs. They are all psychological wombs. So just as the child has to come out of the physical mother's womb at the right time, if it doesn't come, it is not good for the child and for the mother. It has to come. In the same way, a person has to evolve from one womb to the other at the right time. If it doesn't happen, then something unnatural has to be done. In this case, like physical thing, it is cesarean, cut open. That is what we'll find here. Prahlada is waiting with a scissor. So before applying the scissor, let us see the natural process how a person has to evolve. Cesarean is only in the end, isn't it? So we will keep this portion in the end. So what is this Brahmacharya Ashrama? The child goes to a Gurukula, learns the fundamentals of life. What is life? Who am I? What is world? What is God? What is my purpose of life? This is what he learns in a protective atmosphere called Gurukula. It is a womb. Why is it called a womb? Because the child is fully protected and the child is under the guidance of a guru. There is an ashram atmosphere there. The external influence is not inside that ashram. The child is taught the fundamentals. The child is trained in virtues, in values. The child is away from the father and mother because father and mother will not be in a position to give those values. The guru who has been trained in these imparts these values, this knowledge. This is called Brahmacharya Ashrama. Now a stage has to come when the child has to go out of this ashrama. Why? Because life is not only about studying books. Life is about going through experiences. Something he has studied from the textbooks, mere studying is not life. He has to be exposed to life. He has to be exposed to the experiences of life. Then alone he will become mature. So therefore, after Brahmacharya Ashrama comes Grihastha Ashrama. So in Grihastha Ashrama, this person is exposed to the world, exposed to life, exposed to pleasures, exposed to experiences. So he is allowed to go through legitimate pleasures of the world. But at the same time, in the Brahmacharya Ashrama, the warning has been given to him. What is the warning? Remember, the pleasures of the world are ephemeral, temporary. The teachings have been given in the Brahmacharya Ashrama. That the life is impermanent, the relationships are impermanent. Worldly wealth is not going to give you happiness. Your relationship is only with Lord, which is permanent. All the other relationships are impermanent. This teaching has been given when? In the Brahmacharya Ashrama. But now he is going through life. So keeping this knowledge in mind, he is supposed to go through life. So even when he is living amidst imperfections, where is his mind? His mind is always to the perfect God. Even when he is going through these experiences, he is always trying to win over his own weaknesses of mind. Even when he is going through the pleasures of the world, he knows these pleasures are not permanent. He knows that these pleasures can enslave me. He knows that these attachments can enslave me. He knows that these relationships can enslave me. This knowledge he has gained from Brahmacharya Ashrama. Right? So this Grihastha Ashrama is also a womb. Why is it called a womb? It is called a womb because that particular womb will be helpful to you to some extent. It will help you grow. It will give you experiences because only through life's experiences, only after experimenting with life, you can grow out of your imperfections. So this is a womb. Now remember, it is a womb. Means what? After some time you have to come out. But suppose this child is not coming out of this Grihastha Ashrama womb. I hope you are getting what I am saying. If the child doesn't come out of the Grihastha Ashrama womb, then there are scriptures who are like scissors. And this is the part where the scripture acts as a scissor to help the child come out of the Grihastha Ashrama womb. I hope you understand. Then where he has to go? He has to go to another womb. Which is that womb? Vanaprastha womb. What happens in Vanaprastha womb? There, slowly, slowly he withdraws from the world, withdraws from the activities, withdraws from the responsibilities of the world, and more time is given to spiritual pursuits. So slowly he is making his grip strong on spirituality, on God, and slowly he is leaving his grip from the world. He has not left the world. At the same time, he is trying to hold on to God strongly. So both places he is holding on. But slowly, the higher grip is becoming stronger, the lower grip is becoming weaker. This process, this transition state is what is Vanaprastha. And what is Sannyasa? Sannyasa is a stage which has to come after Vanaprastha. What is it? Lower is totally left and higher is totally held on to. Such a person depends only and only on God for his security, for his happiness, for his peace, not on the world. Here, this person totally comes out of the womb and now he is perfect, he is complete, he has become one. So this way, the jiva has to come from one womb to the other. If he gets stuck up anywhere, then there are scriptural portions which will act as a scissor, caesarean. So now with the portion which we are going to see is a caesarean portion. Are you understanding what I am saying? So now these sections are very powerful. Almost like that Bhajagovindam part. Now let us get into this verse. So out of 100 years, 20 gone. In Balya Kaumar Avastha, playfulness, ignorance. Last 20 gone in old age, body is infirm. And now you have 60 years. Out of that 30 gone in sleep. Now the rest 30. How normally 99.99% of the people, how do they spend their time? This is what is described. Okay?
दूरापूरेण कामेन मोहेन च बलीयसा शेषं गृहेषु सक्तस्य प्रमत्तस्यापयातिः.
How does he spend this 30 years of grihasthashrama? दूरापूरेण कामेन, insatiable desires. बलीयसा मोहेन, fully deluded, in the midst of delusion. And what is this delusion? Delusion is, the world is the source of my happiness. This is called delusion. Shesham griheshu saktasya, fully attached to his own home, his own relatives. Pramattasya, inadvertent, careless. Abhayati, his 30 years also is gone. Now here a description is given.
कथं प्रियाया अनुकंपितायाः संगम रहस्यं रुचिरांश्च मंत्रान् सुहृत्सुच स्नेहसितः शिशूनां कलाक्षराणां अनुरक्तचित्तः पुत्रान् स्मरंस्तादुहितृहृदय्या भ्रातृन् स्वसृर्वा पितरौ च दीनौ गृहान् मनोज्ञोरुपरिच्छदांश्च वृत्तिश्च कुल्या पशुभृत्यवर्गान्.
Yes. Now, his attachment is what is described. His attachment, intense attachment to his wife, number one. Suhrutsu, his friends, his relatives, and then to his baby, his child. What kind of child? Shishunam kala aksharanam anurakta chittaha. That lisping of this little baby. So this person is so fond of his child. Chochweet baby, isn't it? Chochweet, yes. So you love to listen to all those blabberings of that child, meaningless prattling, and slowly you are attached. They are all the roots of this samsara vriksha, how it is catching you. So with the wife on one side, with his little children on one side, putran, your sons, duhitra, your daughters, bhratrun, brothers, sisters, parents, your own house, manotnyor parichchadanscha, and those valuable items in the house, your job, vrittischa. Pashu bhritya vargan, your pashus. Once upon a time it was cattle, horse, elephant, etc. Now it has to be car, Benz car and Apache bikes, etc. Bhritya vargan, servants. So this way he is fully tied up with his relatives, with his house, with his friends, with his colleagues, with his, what you call, land, property. What is his condition? Sneha pasher dridhair baddham. Baddham means bound. Bound very well. By what? Pasha means ropes. Sneha pasha it is. So you don't feel like cutting it also, because it is so sweet. Though you are bound, though you lack freedom, but you enjoy it. Sneha pashe dridhair baddham. Dridhai means you don't have any freedom to even move. Your likes and dislikes have been so strong, you have no freedom, but you enjoy that lack of freedom also. How? Koshaskrit iva ihamanaha. Like a worm in the cocoon. It is said that the worm, I think silkworm, it makes that cocoon with its own saliva. That's what I am told. Isn't it? So that worm has created that cocoon. Now it is fully tied up. It has no freedom, but it is enjoying its stay in that cocoon. In that womb, we can say. This is called Grihasthashrama womb. He doesn't want to come out. And now what is his understanding about life? His understanding it is that it is this womb which is giving me security, which is giving me happiness. So therefore, he will try to protect and preserve this womb, this cocoon.
Kutumba poshaya viyannijayuh na buddhyate artham vihatam pramattah sarvatra tapatraya dukhitatma nirvidyate na sva kutumba ramah.
Kutumba poshaya viyannijayuh. The whole lifespan is gone. For what? Kutumba poshaya. For? Kutumba poshanam means what? You can understand. Taking care of this family, etc. Now where is the time for any spiritual pursuit? No time at all. Na buddhyate artham vihatam pramattah. The whole life is gone. In this careless attitude. Totally the purpose of life is forgotten. Sarvatra tapatraya dukhitatma. It is not that he is enjoying it. He is suffering. Moment to moment he is suffering. Near and dear ones are dying one by one. Wickets are falling down. But even then, nirvidyate. He doesn't get that sense that life is impermanent. Now what is his name? Prahlada calls him Swakutumba Ramaha. Instead of Atma Ramaha, what has he become? Kutumba Ramaha. Why so much of criticism? The criticism is, this kutumba is something which is going to fall, which is impermanent. If you hold on to this kutumba, there is all the possibility you are going to suffer. A shock will come to life. Anything can happen in life. Everything is impermanent. Now this person is trying to settle down. Isn't it? After marriage, after getting a job, people try to settle down. Where? In this world which is impermanent, he is trying to settle down permanently. What a foolishness. Can you ever settle down permanently in an impermanent setup? It is something like saying, I will be firmly rooted in a boat which is tossed up and down in the ocean. How can you be firmly rooted in a boat which is tossed up and down? So therefore, now what happens to this person? Now his philosophy is, my happiness comes from my family, from my possessions, from my positions. Now what will he do? He will try to secure it. All his effort is meant only for making all this firm and secure. So therefore, Prahladji says, Ko nvartha trishnam visrajet pranebhyo piya ipsitah yam krinatya subhif preshtai taskaras sevako vanik. So in order to maintain his family, in order to maintain his possessions, what is the one thing required? Money. Isn't it? If you want to maintain a family, kshine vitte kaha parivaraha. Once money is not there, how can you maintain the family? So then money becomes the most important priority in his life. What should be the highest priority in life? God. Now God is no longer the priority. Once Kutumba becomes a priority, money becomes his highest goal of life. And now he's striving to gain this money. Now here Prahlaji says, he doesn't mind even to risk his life to gain wealth. For example, he gives three examples. Taskaraha. Taskaraha means thief. What does the thief do? He risks his life for what? Money. Life also becomes unimportant for him. Wealth becomes more important. Yatha taskaraha sevakaha. Servant. Like for example, the soldiers. They are the sevakas of king. What do? They fight the battle, risking their life. For what? Wealth. Now in that limited sense you have to take. Don't bring in other arguments. Only in that limited sense. Vanik, the merchants, like the fishermen, etc. They go into deep ocean, risking their life. For what? For wealth. So slowly, 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 the money start becoming the most important thing in life. And then what do? See, here we have to take it in the right sense. Earning wealth is not what is criticized. As far as the needs are concerned, we need wealth. But the question is, what is your highest priority in life? If wealth has become the highest priority in life, then definitely the criticism is for you. And a time comes when he is not able to meet the needs because now he is fully indulgent. Now here a term is used. Aupastha jahyam bahu manyamanaha. What is his highest goal? Pleasures of the world. The pleasures of the genitals and the pleasures of the tongue. This is the term used. This has become his goal of life. Now these are all the dangers of grihasthashrama. So now that the sense pleasures have become very important, money has become important, and now money, since money has become important, now he starts earning wealth through illegitimate, unlawful means. Because normal earning will not be sufficient for him.
Vitteshu nityabhinivishta chetah vidvamsa dosham paravitta hartuh prityeha chathyapyajitendriyas tad ashantakamo harate kutumbi.
Now his name is Paravitta Hartuh. Paravitta Harta. The stealer of others' wealth. So you can include all those corruption, the scam and all those bribe, everything under this category. Now what is his condition? Is he happy? Ashantakamaha. He is trying to fulfill all the desires, but can the desires be fulfilled? It is insatiable. Kamarupena kaunteya dushpurena analena cha. Like fire, it is insatiable. Trividham narakasyedam dwaram nashanam atmanah kama krodhastatha lobhah tasmat etatrayam tyajet. There are three doorways to hell. What are they? Kama, desire, krodha, anger and lobha, greed. Now this person is under this greed and now he has literally entered into hell. Ashanta kamaha. Now he is totally disturbed. He is not able to fulfill his desires. Totally disturbed. In this way, he lives a life of sensuousness, licentiousness, a life of an animal, animalistic way of living. So what is the mistake he has done? He has misunderstood the womb of grihasthashrama as a perfect staying place, a permanent staying place. So now instead of God becoming the goal, what has become the goal? This, what you call? This womb itself has become the goal. So not only that he is miserable, he supplies misery to everyone around him. So now Prahlada is using one scissor. Come out of this womb. विद्वानपीथं धनुजाकुटुम्बं पुष्णन् स्वलोकायन कल्पते वै यस्वीयपारक्य विभिन्न भावः तमः प्रपद्येत यथा विमूढः। नाउ सच ए पर्सन में रीड स्क्रिप्चर्स, विद्वान, ही में रीड स्क्रिप्चर्स, ही में लॉजिकली आर्ग्यू ऑल्सो, ही माइट हैव अंडरस्टूड द लॉजिक्स एक्सेट्रा, दैट आई एम द सेल्फ एंड आई एम दिस बॉडी इज नॉन सेल्फ एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा, बट हियर प्रहलाद सेज इट्स ऑफ नो यूज, इट विल जस्ट रिमेन एज अ पीस ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन इन हिज ब्रेन। स्वीय पारक्य विभिन्न भाव तमः प्रपद्येत, एज फार एज हिज अंडरस्टैंडिंग इज कंसर्न, हिज अंडरस्टैंडिंग विल स्टिल रिमेन, द विजन ऑफ प्लूरैलिटी विल स्टिल रिमेन, ही कैन नेवर अटेन द विजन ऑफ वननेस। व्हाई इज इट सेड सो? रिमेंबर, एज फार एज द वर्ल्डली नॉलेज इज कंसर्न, साइंस, मैथमेटिक्स, मेडिसिन, इंजीनियरिंग एक्सेट्रा, मोरालिटी इज नॉट एम्फसाइज्ड। You don't have to be a moral person. You don't have to be what you call a clean person with respect to your values. You don't have to be a truthful person to become what you call a scholar in worldly knowledge. It is not necessary. You can find a corrupt person who is extremely intelligent in physics or mathematics, etc. It is possible. Why? Because to gain the knowledge of the world, purity of mind is not essential. But what about this scriptural knowledge? Na virato duscharita, na shanto na samahitah, na shanta manaso vapi prajnane nainam apnoyat. A person who has not refrained himself from impure ways of living, vulgar ways of living and thinking, a person who has not refrained himself, he can never understand what this self is, what this truth is. So as far as the spiritual knowledge is concerned, mere studying the scriptures will not do. Mere listening to the talks will not do. Then what is important? You must transform yourself. You must transform your way of thinking, your way of living, and then alone this knowledge will enter into you. This is made very clear. You can't take spirituality as a side business. This is also here. Let that also come. As far as other things are concerned, you can do that. Correspondence course you can do. But as far as spirituality is concerned, as long as you have not given the highest priority to this knowledge will not take place. Nayam atma pravachanena labhyah namedhaya na bahuna shrutena यमै वेश वृणुते तेन लभ्य तस्येष आत्मा विवृणुते तनुं स्वा। अंडरस्टैंड दैट दिस आत्मा विल नॉट बी गेन्ड बाय योर एक्सट्रीम इंटेलिजेंस, बाय योर स्कॉलरशिप, बाय योर लिसनिंग और स्टडिंग द स्क्रिप्चर्स। नो, हु गेट्स इट? द वन हु हैज चोसन इट गेट्स इट। नाउ व्हाट डू यू मीन चोसन इट? Chosen, it means one who is ready to do anything. Any sacrifice is nothing for that person. Such a person gains it. And what is the greatest sacrifice? The greatest sacrifice is living a pure life. Intelligent way of living. Pure way of living. Moral way of living. This is what is emphasized. So one has to, even while living the grihastha ashrama, one has to be morally pure. Morally clean. Marriage doesn't mean licentiousness. It is not a license to indulge. But it is an opportunity where we try to come out of our weaknesses so that over a period of time, knowing the defects of everything worldly, we are able to embrace the divine. That is the purpose. So it is a stage, it is an intermediary stage, it is not a permanent goal. Is this clear? This clarity has to be there, otherwise you are stuck. 15th chapter comes with that samsara vriksha. What is that samsara vriksha? It is nothing but this only. बट ए पर्सन हु लिव्स इंटेलिजेंटली, गृहस्थाश्रम इज नॉट ए डेंजर, इट इज ओनली अ ब्लेसिंग. जस्ट लाइक द वूम्ब इज अ ब्लेसिंग फॉर द चाइल्ड, फॉर अ 3 months, 4 month चाइल्ड, दैट वूम्ब इज अ ब्लेसिंग. द चाइल्ड वॉट यू कॉल डेवलप्स, इजंट इट? सो गृहस्थाश्रम इज ऑल्सो ए वूम्ब विच कैन हेल्प अस इवॉल्व. बट आफ्टर सम टाइम डोंट मेक इट ए परमानेंट प्लेस ऑफ रेजिडेंस. दैट इज द मैसेज हियर. सो रिमेंबर, दिस पोर्शन इज नॉट मेन फॉर एवरी वन, इट इज ओनली मेन फॉर दोज हू हैव रीच द 9th or 10th मंथ ऑलरेडी. इट इज नॉट मेन फॉर ऑल. सो डिफरेंट पीस ऑफ एडवाइस इज गिवन टू डिफरेंट स्टेजेस ऑफ साधकास. इफ यू आर हाईली मैच्योर्ड, दिस यू विल वेलकम. If you are not matured, you can't even listen to it. It becomes a kind of irritation for you. Then understand that you are not yet matured. In Bhagavatam, you have different portions for different people. For children also some portions are there. Some goody-goody stories are there. These are all meant for advanced sadhaks. So if you find that this is too much, okay, just bypass it. Bypass. Okay. This knowledge has to be there. Then life is comfortable. So therefore, oh Daitya Balakas. Remember, all this advice is given to these little children.
Tato vidurat parihrutya daityah daityeshu sangam vishayatmakeshu upeta narayanam adidevam samukta sangairishitopavargah.
Tataha, therefore, oh my dear friends, Vishayatmakeshu Daityeshu Sangam Parihritya. Give up this evil company of the sensuous Daityas. Daityas means devilish people. So give up this evil company, Dussang. Give up this Dussang. They will mislead you. The teaching which you are getting in this Gurukula is not right. They are focusing only on Artha and Kama. That is not the purpose of life. Give up this evil company. Because when you are in the evil company, you will be misled. Andhena niyamana yathandaha. The blind people are leading you. We are blind, no doubt, but even our leaders are blind. So Prahlada is saying, your teachers are also blind. Don't follow them. Parihritya, give up this dussang, this evil association with anyone who preaches sensuality. Give up this evil association. Then what are we supposed to do? Upeta Narayanam Adidevam. Take complete refuge in Narayana, the primeval being. The Supreme Being. Samukta Sangehi Ishitaha Apavargaha. He is the one unto whom the wise people, the noble people take refuge in. So therefore take refuge in Narayana. Take refuge in the devotees of God. Take refuge in the great renunciates, the saints and the sages who will take you to that God. That alone is satsang. Everything else is dussang. Anyone who preaches the greatness of sense pleasures, the greatness of worldly wealth, consider it to be an evil company and set them aside. Seek God alone. He alone is permanent. Hold on to Him. Is it difficult? Oh friends, it is very easy.
Na hyachyutam prinayatah bhakhvayaso suratmajah आत्मत्वात् सर्वभूतानां सिद्धत्वादिह सर्वतः.
इट इज वेरी ईजी टू प्लीज द लॉर्ड.
बहु आसायः न,
देयर इज नो मच डिफिकल्टी इन प्लीजिंग द लॉर्ड.
वै आत्मत्वात् सर्वभूतानां आत्मत्वात् सिद्धत्वात् सर्वतः सर्वभूतानां.
दैट भगवान इज द वेरी सेल्फ ऑफ अस. And He is ever available as the very self. He is available everywhere. at all times. So therefore, seek that Supreme Lord alone.
Paravareshu bhuteshu brahmantasthavare ब्रह्मांतस्थावरादिषु एक एव परोह्यात्मा भगवान ईश्वरो व्ययः.
वेयर डज दैट भगवान एग्जिस्ट? ही इज देयर फ्रॉम ब्रह्माजी द हाईएस्ट अमंग द क्रिएटर अप टू इवन ए ब्लेड ऑफ ग्रास. इट इज ही अलोन एवरीवेयर. इट इज ही अलोन. एवरी वन इज ही अलोन.
So seek that Bhagwan who is imperishable, who is the very self of all beings. So therefore, O Daityas, what are you supposed to do? I will tell you.
Tasmat sarveshu bhuteshu dayam kuruta sauhridam asuram bhavamun mujya yaya tushyat adhokshajah.
Tasmat, therefore, sarveshu bhuteshu dayam kuruta. What you must do? Be friendly with all. Love everyone. Be compassionate to all. Asuram bhavam unmuch. Give up your asuric tendencies. Anger, lust, greed, jealousy. These are all very natural to daityas. That is why this specific mention. Because they are all born in asura kulas. For asuras, anger, greed, etc. is natural. So therefore, oh my dear friends, give up all these kinds. They are not the right way of living. Love everyone. Because what you see in others, there is no other person. You alone, the self alone is expressing in different body, mind, intellect equipments. So it is you alone in others. So love everyone with this vision of oneness. Cultivate noble virtues. Cultivate Daivi Sampat, divine virtues. And give up Asuri Sampat, devilish virtues. It's not virtues, devilish qualities. Daivi Sampat you develop, Asuri Sampat you give up. Then what will happen? Yaya tushyati adhokshajaha. This will please the Lord. Bhagwan will be pleased with you when you strive to cultivate noble virtues in you. This is what you have to do. Now the question is, how will we know whether Bhagwan is pleased with us or not? The answer is simple. When your mind is peaceful, calm, quiet, when you start loving your mind because of its cheerfulness, understand Bhagwan is pleased with you. When your mind is cheerful, when your mind is peaceful, when your mind effortlessly entertains noble virtues, when your mind is obedient, is disciplined, understand it is the grace of the Lord. To put it the other way, when the mind is disturbed, extroverted, agitated, fickle, wandering, then understand Bhagwan is not pleased with you. This is the proof. Any situation, if you want to know whether Bhagwan is pleased with you or not, you have to just look at your mind. So this way, O Balakas, O my dear friends, live life. This is the very purpose. And once Bhagwan is pleased, what is that which you will not attain? Because everything is under his control. Tushte cha tatra kimalabhyam ananta adye. What is impossible once he is pleased with you? So this is what your goal should be. What should be your goal in life? Strive to please God. And how can you please God? Be good to all, love all, be compassionate to all, and remove all asuric tendencies in you, which is natural to you because you are asura balakas. It is there in your blood. So you will have to put forth extra effort to eradicate it.
Dharmartha kama iti yo bihitas trivargah ईक्षात्रै नयदमौ विविधा च वार्ता मन्ये तदेतदखिलं निगमस्य सत्यं स्वात्मार्पणं स्वसुहृदः परमस्य पुंसः.
माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, व्हाट इज द एसेंस ऑफ द वेदास? इन द वेदास यू विल फाइंड सो मेनी टॉपिक्स डेल्ट विथ. धर्मशास्त्र, नीतिशास्त्र, न्यायशास्त्र, so many do's and don'ts, so many rules and regulations, so many rituals, complicated rituals, all these things you will find in the Vedas. Vividhacha Varta. But understand, what is the essence of the Veda? In my understanding, manye tadeda dakhilam nigamasya satyam. There is only one essential message of the Veda. And what is the essential message? Swa-atma arpanam. Swa-atma arpanam means total surrender. Unto whom? Paramasya swa-suhrudaha. Unto that Supreme Lord who is the friend of all, who is residing in the hearts of all. This is the essential message of the Vedas. If you have understood this, you have understood the entire Veda. Finished. Urdhva moolamada shakam ashvattham prahuravyayam chandamsyasya parnani yastam veda savedavit. Enough. If you have understood this much, over. What is the most important thing? Urdhva moolam. That is what you have to understand. The entire samsara is residing where? The Moola is Urdhvam Bhagavan. Once you have understood this, matter is over. So once you have understood this essence of the Veda, what is the essence of the Veda? There are so many topics. Don't get into all that. In a pill form, Prahlada gives. Just gulp that pill and everything is okay. The pill is hold on to God. He is alone, is permanent. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa used to give this example. When you go to a mango orchard, what you should do? Don't sit and count the number of trees, number of twigs and number of leaves, etc. Go to the ripe mango and eat it, suck it, enjoy. That is the purpose for going into a mango orchard. Don't waste your time in all other nonsense. Isn't it? Eat mango, enjoy. In the same way, when you live life, what is that mango, ripe mango? That is Bhagavan. Seek that Bhagavan alone. Don't waste your time in all other nonsense. Now everyone, all these children were looking. Because they were also of the same age. But look at his knowledge, look at his wisdom. So naturally, their face, it was very clear. This question was clear. From where did you get it? You were also studying just like us in this ashram. Shanda, Amarka, they are the teachers. But how did you get this knowledge? Now Prahalaji is giving that Guru par, what is that? Guru Shishya Parampara. Actually, whatever I am saying, it is not mine. It has come from the higher source. Now what is that higher source?
Jnanam tadedadamalam duravapamaha नारायणो नरसख किल नारदाय एकांतिनां भगवतस्तदकिंचनानां पादारविंदरजसा प्लुतदेहिनां स्यात्.
This pure knowledge, pristine knowledge, amalam jnanam, it's very rare. Duravapam, very rare. It's a great secret. What I am telling you, everyone doesn't know this. Actually, it has come from Narayana, Narayana Rishi. Nara Narayana, Rishis are there. So that Narayana Rishi had given this to Naradji. This knowledge was given to Naradji and Naradji gave it to me. So actually, it is not my knowledge. But this knowledge can become yours also. No doubt it is rare, no doubt it is a very great secret, but you can also gain it. What is the qualification needed to gain this knowledge? Ekantinam bhagavatah tad akinchananam padaravinda rajasa pluta dehinam. So what one has to do? The one who is bathed in the dust of the lotus feet of akinchananam, of those devotees who have none other than the Lord for security and support. Bathing in Plutadehinam, bathing in Padaravinda Rajasa, bathing in the dust of the lotus feet of Akinchananam, the devotees who have none other than God as support. Ekantinam, those whose mind is fully into the Lord. Single pointed effort those who make to reach God. If you take bath in that dust, you will also gain this knowledge. Again, as I told you, it is not literal. What does it mean? It shows that humility, the surrender, that feeling that, oh Lord, I don't know anything. I am a helpless child. Please save me. That kind of total self-negation is what is pointed out here. Those people who have this attitude, they will also gain this knowledge.
Srutametanmaya purvam jnanam vijnana sanyutam dharmam bhagavatam shuddham naradad devadarshanam.
This knowledge I gained from Narada Rishi. Jnanam vijnana sanyutam, this knowledge as well as experience, knowledge and wisdom, this path towards the divine, this I gained from Narada Rishi. And when he said that, the boys had a question. What is the question? Question is interesting. So although Daitya Putras, they asked,
Prahladatvam vayam chapi nartenyam vidmahe gurum etabhyam guru putrabhyam balanam api ishvaro.
Prahlada, tell us one thing. As far as we are concerned, we don't know any other gurus other than these two, Shanda and Amarka. Other than these two, we don't know anyone else. From where did you gain this knowledge then? You are saying that you got it from Naraji, but there is no occasion for you to come across Naraji.
Balasyantah purasthasya mahat sango duranvayah chindinas samshayam saumya syachet vishrambhakaranam.
As far as this Gurukula is concerned, there is no way in which Naraji can come. Because if he had come, we would have observed him. So definitely in this Gurukula he had not come. And I don't think he would have come in the palace also, when you were with your mother, very small. In your palace also there is no scope for his coming, because Hiranyakashipu is there. So when you were with your mother, when you are very young, there is no possibility for Naraji to give this knowledge. Here in Gurukula also, there is no possibility by which Naraji would have given you this knowledge. Then tell us, where exactly you got this knowledge from Naraji? So then Prahlada said, okay, that part also I will tell you. So then he narrates that story, how he got this knowledge from Naraji. So he answers this question.
Pitari prasthite smakam tapase mandarachalam yudhyodyamam param chakruhu vibhudhadanavan prati.
So when my father had gone to do this tapas to that Manda, what is that? Mandara mountains. When he had gone to do tapas, devatas, finding that is the right opportunity to attack, they came with a huge army and attacked the asuras. Because now Hiranyakashipu is not there. He has gone for tapas. And probably they might have seen him also doing tapas and all these bones, etc. So here it is written, Pipilikaihi ahiriva दिष्ट्या लोकोपपातनः पापेन पापो भक्षेति. दैट क्रूअल फेलो, सो मच ऑफ सिंस ही हैज डन दैट हिज ओन सिंस हैव ईटन हिम अवे, जस्ट लाइक द एंट्स हैव ईटन हिज बॉडी. Ants have eaten the snake. Just like the ants eat away the snake, in the same way his own sins have eaten him up. By looking at his body, which was all bones. So saying thus, these devatas attacked the asuras. Then what did these asuras do? Seeing the huge army of devatas coming, all of them ran. कलत्र पुत्र मित्राप्तान गृहान पशु परिच्छदान नावेक्षमाणास्त्वरिताः सर्वे प्राण परीप्सवः. सो ऑल दोस अतुरास नॉट बॉदरिंग अबाउट देयर वाइफ सन फ्रेंड्स रिलेटिव्स हाउस देयर पोसेशंस एक्सेट्रा दे लेफ्ट एवरीथिंग एंड रैन फॉर देयर लाइफ लुकिंग एट दिस ह्यूज आर्मी. एंड व्हाट डिड दिस देवतास डू? व्यलुंपन राज शिबिरम अमराजय कांक्षिणः इंद्रस्तु राज महिषी मातरम मम चाग्रहीत. सो दीज देवतास दे केम लूटेड द एंटायर पैलेस एंड देन इंद्र वेंट एंड हेल्ड द मदर ऑफ प्रहलाद. व्हाट इज हर नेम? कयाधु. ही हेल्ड हर. इंद्रस्तु राज महिषी मातरम मम चाग्रहीत. नियमानां भयोद्विग्नां रुदतीं कुरुरीमय कुरुरीमिव यदृच्छयागतस्तत्र देवर्षिर्ददृशे पथि. सो ही वाज ड्रैगिंग हर अवे, टेकिंग हर टू हिज अबोर्ड, एंड दिस लेडी वाज आल्सो क्राइंग एंड वीपिंग हेल्पलेसली लाइक ए बर्ड. हेल्पलेसली दिस वुमन वाज क्राइंग, ट्रेम्बलिंग विथ फियर. And this Indra was dragging her. At that time, Naradji saw this scene. And then Naradji said, Rahamainam surapate netur marhasya nagasam muncha muncha mahabhaga satim paraparigraham. Oh Indra, oh noble-minded Indra, what are you doing? She is someone else's wife. You are showing your revenge against Hiranyakashipu unto this poor helpless lady. It's a sin. Don't do this. Leave her. At that time, Indra said, Astesya jathere viryam avishahyam suradvishah asyatam yavat prasavam moksheertha padavim gatah. So then Indra said, No, I am taking her for a purpose. In her womb, there is this poisonous seed of Hiranyakashipu. So once, till she delivers the child, let her be with me. Once I finish the child off, then I will leave her. I am more worried about the fellow who is inside. Hiranyakashipu himself is like this. Then who is going to come then? So this is the purpose. Once everything is over, once I finish that fellow inside, I will leave her. Then Naradji said, Oh fool, do you know who is inside? Ayam nishkilbishas sakshat mahabhagavato mahan toyana prapsyate samstham anantanucharo bali. Indra, you don't know who is there inside. He is the greatest devotee of Vishnu. Bali, very very powerful. Even if you try, you cannot kill him. The fellow inside is not an ordinary one. Mahabhagavatah is. Na prapsyate samstha. You can't do anything. He is ever protected by the Lord. And when Indra heard that Bhagavan's devotee is inside, immediately he left her. Ityuktam vihayendrah devarsher manayan vachah anantapriya bhaktyainam parikramya divam yayau. When Indra heard that Bhagavan's devotee is there inside the womb of Kayadhu, he immediately left her. Not only he left her, he did pradakshina of her, did namaskar, and then left. did namaskar to the child who is within. Because of his love for the divine, Indra left her.
ततो नो मातरम ऋषि समानीय निजाश्रमम् आश्वासे होष्यताम वत्से यावत्ते भर्तुरागमः.
So then Naraji told her, O Amma, do one thing, you remain with me in the ashram. Till your husband comes back, you remain in the ashram. You will be safe here. Thus saying, she remained in the ashram. What did she do?
Rishim paryacharat tatra bhaktya paramayasati antarvatni swagarbhasya kshemayeccha prasutaye.
So in the ashram, that Kayadhu remained there serving this Narad Rishi. She was a very noble lady, very devoted lady. Serving this Rishi, she remained there with prayers. Prayers for the child. O Lord, may this child be healthy. For the welfare of the child, she prayed and remained. And not only that, she prayed one more thing. O Lord, see to it that I deliver this child only once my husband comes back. This way, she remained there. And what did Naraji do? Naraji knew who is there inside. So he started bombarding with spiritual instructions to her, keeping in mind this child. This lady was not understanding anything. But the one whose understanding mattered was understanding.
What is said? Rishikarunikastasyah pradadu bhayamishwarah dharmasya tattvam jnanam cha mamapyuddishya nirmalam.
That compassionate Rishi, who had thorough understanding about everything about divine, he in elaborate, he discussed the path to reach the divine and also the nature of the divine, jnanam, and the path to attain that supreme knowledge. Everything, the path to develop devotion of knowledge, how to gain knowledge, everything in detail, he described it to her. But at the same time, mam api uddishya, keeping in mind me who was there in her womb.
तत्तु कालस्य दीर्घत्वात् स्त्रीत्वात्मा तु स्थिरोदधे ऋषीणानुग्रहीतं मां नाधुना प्यज्जहात् स्मृतिः.
By my mother, after so many days, she forgot whatever Naraji taught her. She was, what you call, not that intelligent. So she forgot everything, but I was listening to everything. By this Rishi's blessing and grace, I am even now, I remember whatever instructions he had given. So that knowledge is still with me. This knowledge I am going to give you. So now Prahlada is going to give the essence of the scriptural knowledge in summary.
What does he say? भवतामपि भूयान्मे यदि श्रद्धते वचः वैशारदीधि श्रद्धातः श्रीबालान च मे यथा.
So this knowledge which I have gained from Naraji, now I will give it to you. In brief, you can also gain it provided
श्रद्धते वचः.
You must have faith and pay total attention to what I say. I will give you. You can also get it. Have faith in this knowledge. Thus, now begins the scriptural teachings, which is the essence of Vedanta, which we will see in the evening. So this one part, the child listening from the womb, this normally they quote in order to say that the mother while in pregnancy must always expose to good things, whether you are sleeping or not, the fellow is there inside. Listen to satsang, listen to bhajan, listen to all such devotional things. It is affecting the child within. So if you want a good child, a noble child, a virtuous child, then the mother has to do this. Keep away from dussang and expose yourself to satsang. So that very young age, from the womb itself, this samskara has to be given. In our Hindu samskara, this is also one part. The mother should not expose herself to all these worldly things, extroverted things.
सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाः सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत् असतो मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमय ॐ शांति 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 हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो